Hi everyone, this is your biology class. I'm your teacher Seema Treja. Student, in previous lecture we studied the topic spermatogenesis, how is the sperm formation takes place. In this lecture we are going to discuss the hormonal control on spermatogenesis and we also discuss the structure of sperm. So first we will discuss the hormonal control on spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis starts at the age of puberty. At the age of puberty, from the hypothalamus, there is the release of gonadotropin releasing hormone. Increased level of gonadotropin releasing hormone acts on the anterior pituitary gland, which stimulates the anterior pituitary gland to release two hormones, luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone. Luteinizing hormone acts on the leading cells. Leading cells are present into the interstitial fluid and then leading cells release an hormone which is known as the male sex hormone, that is testosterone. This testosterone hormone helps in the process of spermatogenesis. Another hormone which is released from pituitary gland under the influence of gonadotropin releasing hormone is follicle stimulating hormone. These follicle stimulating hormone acts on the Sertoli cells present into the seminiferous tubule of testis. These Sertoli cells release some special factors which help in the process of spermiogenesis. What is spermiogenesis? That is spermatid changes into functional sperm, motile sperm. The process is known as spermiogenesis. So this is the hormonal control which helps in the formation of sperm in case of human male. Now we will discuss the structure of sperm. Sperm produced by the process of spermatogenesis are haploid. They consist of X number of chromosomes in them. That is, only one set of chromosome is present in them, as they are the product of meiosis division. In the germ cell, meiosis division takes place and haploid sperms are produced. Sperms are flagellated structure. They are the motile structure. They have the power to move. Sperm consists of four parts: head region, neck region, middle piece and tail region. Head region is further divided into two parts. It consists of the nucleus and tip of the sperm is known as the acrosome. So here I am going to draw the structure of sperm for the clear understanding. That is the structure of sperm. First part is head region, which is made up of two parts. Tip is known as the acrosome and behind the acrosome there is present the nucleus region. Nucleus is somewhat pointed at the anterior end and broader at the posterior end. On the posterior end there is present a depression in the nucleus. Inside the nucleus, there is present genetic material and protein. Tip of the nucleus, there is present acrosome. This acrosome is produced from Golgi body. Acrosome release sperm lysine hormone which help in the formation of hole in the egg membrane so that the sperm enter inside the egg for fertilization. This part is known as the nucleus. Together acrosome and nucleus constitute the first part of the sperm, that is known as the head region. Below the head region there is present neck region, which is very small part. Here is present two centriole. One centriole is present in the depression of the nucleus. What is the function of this centriole? This helps in the formation of spindle fibers. When the after fertilization zygote is formed, and in zygote first division takes place, that time centriole helps in the formation of spindle fibers. We called it as proximal centriole. Another centriole is present where the neck ends. This is known as distal centriole. What is the function of distal centriole? From the distal centriole, axial filaments are produced. Third part, that is the middle piece. This is the middle piece region. In the middle piece region, there is present the spiral shaped ribbon like mitochondria around the axial filaments. In the center, there is present axial filament. And around the axial filament, there is present ribbon like spiral shaped mitochondria. Which provide energy to the sperm so that the sperm easily move. The fourth part is the tail region. That is the tail region. Around the entire structure of sperm, there is present the plasma membrane. This is the plasma membrane. In case of sperm, we called mitochondria as Nebenkern. One more sheath is present that starts from the anterior half of the nucleus, that is the fibrillar sheath. And we called it as galea. This is known as the galea. It is a fibrous sheath which covers the anterior half of the nucleus and acrosome. So one extra sheath is present around the nucleus in the anterior half of the portion, and it also covers the acrosome region. One more sheath is present here, lower half, which covers the lower half of the nucleus region and middle piece region. Starts from the lower half of the nucleus and also covers the middle piece region. This is present inside the plasma membrane, and we called it as Manchetti. So this is the structure of sperm, made up of four parts. First part is head region, which is made up of two parts. The tip of the head is known as the acrosome, which release the sperm lysin. Sperm lysin dissolves the egg membrane and makes the entry of sperm inside the egg for fertilization. The second part of head is the nucleus, in which genetic material is present. Next part is neck region. Neck region is very small part. In which two centrioles are there. Proximal centriole. What is the function of proximal centriole? It forms the spindle fibers. When the first cell division takes place in the zygote, second centriole is the distal centriole, which forms the axial filament, which provides the motility, helps in the motility of the sperm. Third part is middle piece. In the middle piece, around the axial filament, there is present the spiral shaped mitochondria, and we call the mitochondria as Nibbankern. This mitochondria provides the energy to the sperm to move. And the last part is the tail, which is helping the lashing movement of the sperm. So every part has its own function. This is all about in this video. Thank you so much.